Dad, you've been busy again this week, I can see. What have you done here? And you want to talk us through the latest update on the cycle cart?
Yeah, hi everybody. This week I've managed to nearly finish the front end and front assembly totally, and I've mounted it into the chassis, so that I know exactly what goes where and what doesn't go where it should do. And I've been happy with the way it's progressing, and I'm not touching the front end anymore at this stage. I'm working on the rear axle and the engine component from this point on.
So we got last week we were showing people you had fabricated the front.
Yeah, I built the front axle,
Yeah.
and then during the week I've manufactured all the components to fit it all together. The shackles, the spring hangers, the radius arms, and bolted it all together. So it looks the way it hopefully should finish.
So you've got, obviously these are
Yeah,
part of the.
they're just temporary steering arms,
Yep, and.
as part of to make it for me to be able to relate to it visually, so I can progress mentally and visually to the next stage. I won't be touching the steering or any components in the front, like I say, until I've completed the rear end now.
All right. So you were showing me just before what your idea was going to be for attaching the steering column and how you were going to look at having the
Yeah,
body set up.
what my plan is, I'm going to build a half a roll bar here with the steering column attached to it there. It'll be open on this side. My intention with that is so that I can, when I build the body, I can hinge the body down the middle and fold the body up so that for me, I can just slide into the car and slide out of it when I while I'm using it, because it's too hard for me to hop into a car now, so I'm going to make the whole body hinge up to one side.
So that'll take pressure off your shoulders
Oh,
and
everything. Yeah, I just physically can't. I physically have difficulty climbing in and out of the cars. I can do it, but I need assistance.
Yeah,
And
okay.
if I do it this way, I can operate the vehicle by myself without any assistance.
Cool. All right, let's have a look at what you're getting set up for this week at the back of the car. All right, Dad, you want to talk us through what you've done at the back and what your plan is for the next week or so?
The rear axle assembly I've started. I've mounting the axle through the chassis. It'll have bearings and everything attached to it eventually. At the moment, it's just sitting here so that I've got some concept of what goes where, and starting to make measurements and put a plan and a design together. So we've got obviously the rear axle and the engine clutch assembly, and a cardboard sprocket at this stage. I don't know how that's going to go. I'm hoping to get a metal one. I'm hoping I don't need to constantly use a cardboard one. And yeah, there's a lot of machining involved in this part of the build. So this will take a little bit longer to put together. Maybe another week or two before I get to the next stage.
Okay. And you did say that you've received the sprocket, but it needs a bit of work done on it.
Yeah, the sprocket. It's easy to say. It's easier to explain. The sprocket that I purchased, the only one that I could get, being a 60-tooth sprocket, comes with a huge boss on it, and obviously I've got to machine the boss off to fit it to the peerless diff. So this is the sprocket problem that I'm finding. I can't buy sprockets that are close to what I need here.
That's what you were saying last week about how hard it is to find sprockets in
Yeah,
Australia.
that's right. Yeah, I can buy the direct sprocket that bolts straight to that peerless diff in America, but I can't buy it here.
And that thing's heavy.
Yeah, that's heavy.
Yeah.
That's probably about 5 kg.
Yeah, easy. That's an
Yeah,
easy 5 kilos, yeah.
so I've got to reduce take keep the boss off to get rid of the weight.
All right, so what's your rough plan for this week? What are you looking at doing back here?
This week I'll set the rear axle in correctly, set it all up properly, and get the engine in the correct relationship to the rear axle. And that should, I'd like to actually get it to a stage where this is running and ready to go.
Okay, awesome. So that's the rough plan for this week. I can see, me not having much knowledge of any of this sort of stuff. There was a couple of things at the front that I just thought you might want to point out for some people as well that you didn't really talk about in the last video, and that is these things here that you've that you fabricated.
Yeah, these are radius arms.
Okay.
I built them on a traditional old style hot rod design, and I was very happy with the way they came up first time. I didn't have to make them two or three times and waste all that effort. So no, I was extremely happy with the radius arms, and you have to have the radius arms on a transverse spring front axle.
Okay. All right. So there's been plenty of work done. I guess we'll leave you to it for this week. You're going to need me to come and give you a hand with anything?
Probably, yeah. I'll need a hand with a few things over the next couple of weeks because there's a lot of lifting and removing and maybe even taking the chassis off the frame and doing some welding on it.
Okay. Because I did notice you told me at the start of the week that you needed me to come around and give you a hand to lift the engine.
Yeah.
And you've done that yourself.
Yeah, I managed to get that out here.
Yeah. All right. So I'll probably come around during the week and help Dad out with a couple of things. But yeah, as you guys can see, it's starting to look more like a cycle cart than it was a couple of weeks ago when we laid everything out.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Cool. All right. Well, anything else to sign off with, Dad?
No. Just keep up with what I'm doing. And if there's anything I can help with as far as advice or answer any questions you've got, just give us a buzz.
Yeah. Just leave a comment down below if you guys have got any questions about anything that Dad has done with the cycle cart so far. If you've got any questions about how anything's been fabricated, how certain things are going to work. If you're curious, just leave a comment down below. We've also got Dad's email address in down below as well. So if you want to send through an email and keep it private, you can do that too. But until next week, we'll sign off, and hopefully next week it'll be looking even more like a cycle cart.
That's my plan.
All right. We'll see you later.
Thank you.